The 5 A's of obesity management. Assessment. Once you have asked permission to discuss health and weight with your patient, you can then move into assessment. Your goal here is to assess obesity-related risks and potential root causes of weight gain, as well as drivers, complications, and barriers to weight management. It is valuable to assess the youth's lived experience in their body and with their body weight so we don't make any assumptions, can understand where their priorities are, and identify any potential barriers. You can ask questions like, do you have any concerns or worries about your body weight? Do you feel your weight makes anything more difficult for you to do physically and or socially? Does anyone make comments, tease, bother you at school or home about your weight? You can also assess body image by using questions like, do you feel comfortable in your body? Is there anything you would like to change about your body? What do you think would change in your life if your body weight changed? It is common for children and youth living with obesity to react emotionally when asked these questions. However, if asked sensitively, and if the youth feels heard, you will likely develop a deeper understanding of their lived experience and gain their trust. Next, we can move on to assess the main domains of health that are impacted by body weight or that can make weight management more challenging. To do this, we can use the 4 M's framework that breaks these domains down into 4 categories. Metabolic health, biomechanical health, mental health, and milieu, or social health. Using the 4 M's framework, we can identify root causes, complications and drivers of obesity, and barriers to weight management. Let's discuss each of the 4 M's in more detail. Metabolic health issues include type 2 diabetes, dyslipidemia, hypertension, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, or polycystic ovary syndrome. Metabolic complications are most likely to present during puberty, which is a period of increased insulin resistance. Screening for metabolic complications in those at risk is critical as they are often asymptomatic. Screening should be done annually after puberty and/or after 10 years of age as long as the patient's BMI remains above the 97th percentile according to the WHO growth charts. Metabolic complications of obesity are highly responsive to health-promoting behaviors like how we eat, move, sleep, and how we cope. We can see significant improvement in metabolic health through the adoption of health behaviors with little or no change in body weight. Biomechanical complications include obstructive sleep apnea, gastroesophageal reflux disease, musculoskeletal pain, intertrigo, and stress incontinence. Appropriate healthcare support to address biomechanical complications effectively is essential for successful weight management. For example, management of musculoskeletal pain can improve engagement in exercise and activities of daily living, including active play. Mental health issues can often be related to bullying, teasing, and social exclusion, making youth with obesity more vulnerable to chronic stress, high body self-consciousness, and negative mental health outcomes. Some individuals have pre-existing mental health issues that promote the onset of obesity, whether it's through impacted sleep, activity levels, eating habits, or medications. Learning disorders, ADHD, different types of disabilities, anxiety, and past history of trauma are more common among those living with obesity and can make weight management more challenging. Screening for symptoms of disordered eating, such as restrictive eating or dieting, stress or emotional eating, and binge eating, are important potential drivers for weight gain and low self-image. To screen for these behaviors, you can ask questions like, do you sometimes eat or think of food when you feel stressed or bored? Do you ever feel out of control when you're eating or find it hard to stop? Do you ever skip any meals, like breakfast or lunch? Milieu, or social health, includes things like family health, stressors, income, food environment, opportunities for physical activity, sleep habits, and school support. To best support healthy children, we need to support their parents and caregivers' physical, mental, and financial health. School can be a big source of stress for children with obesity. Bullying and harassment can make school feel unsafe and may cause children to socially withdraw, affecting academic performance, social life, and mental health. Supporting children in their school environment can positively impact their mental and physical health and give them the confidence to succeed. Once you have assessed the 4 M's of health, you can then identify potential drivers of weight gain and barriers to weight management. To recap, the goal of your assessment is to assess the potential root causes of weight gain, as well as drivers, complications, and barriers to weight management using the 4 M's framework, which include metabolic health, biomechanical health, mental health, and milieu, or social health. Make sure to watch the next video in the 5A series, advise, agree, assist.